If we could all please stand together. It's so good to see you on this morning. Father, we just thank you. Father, that even as we just pray, God, that we are houses of prayer, God. Father, we just thank you right now that by your Spirit, God, that you would just continue, God, to let your kingdom come and will be done in and through us, God, as a body, Lord. Father, we just ask right now, God, that your presence, Father, would just even increase, Father, in this place, Lord, in the name of Jesus, God. We are here to worship you, Jesus. We thank you, God, that our praise is a weapon, Lord. Father, we thank you that we're here to worship you on the stage, God. We give you all our worship on the stage, God. Hallelujah. We worship you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's give him the fruit of my lips this morning. Hallelujah. Lord, your word is Jesus. I'm somebody, Lord.
Oh, Thank you. Thank you. Oh, yeah. I will lift it higher. With repentance.
with action. That's how you lift weights. And we know that the word glory means the bold. It means a heavy weight. And many of us are not prepared for it. That's why we don't experience it in our meetings. Because it will literally kill us. Our bodies cannot handle it. And this is a physical as well as a spiritual explanation. That there has to be a physical preparation. She did so good with this song tonight, this morning. The last time she did it, I said, oh no, you didn't have enough stamina. You ran out of breath. That could have gone on for 3 more minutes. And she came in with stamina today. She was able to carry the weight of that song. It's the same thing with worship. If you don't have stamina in the presence of God, you're not going to be able to carry heavy worship. That's why about 15 minutes in, some of you guys check out.
Worship there. Some of you guys need community. Your ability
you to worship God, the presence of God is going to be shifted when you're around people that love to worship, that have that 90% of their talk is about the presence of God, about prophecy and the glory and the goodness of Jesus. Some of you guys are unable to enter into worship because when you go back home, the rest of your life, the week, is bombarded by things that feed your flesh but not the spirit. Amen. So one, he had community. Then in this moment, Mary comes out with this perfume. And this is a life message for me. I live by it. She comes out and Judas automatically is like, oh my gosh. Now several things here. I'm not preaching today. My husband is. But I feel like this is really important as we go into Holy Week. We have caught a fast starting tomorrow morning. We'll put up the flyer at 6 a.m. We're going to pray as a church. We've opened it up to the public. But Judas begins to growl in his heart. And it was really interesting because Jesus knew his heart but also allowed him to keep the purse, right? He always had kept the purse. It just shows that Jesus wasn't married to money. Like, it didn't mean anything to him. Because it said that Judas would help himself to it. It says this in this chapter. Go read it, John 12. When you read the word help, it means, they said that he pilgrimaged. Pilfered. He literally would not just help himself. You know how some people steal and they can hide it? No. But anyway, he's there. And Mary comes out with this perfume and begins to burst it open. Two people in the same room with the same presence. And Mary begins to anoint his feet with the oil. It said that oil was worth so much money. And in that day, what would happen when a visitor came into your house, they would anoint their head with a little bit of oil and they would wash their feet with water. But Mary understood the worth of Jesus, that she washed her feet with the oil that should have just been dabbed on his head. She washed his feet with it. And Judas says that should have been given to the poor. Right? In his heart, he knows that should have really been given to me. Two people, same weight of presence in the room, different responses. Oh, that was too long. I don't know what those songs are. I don't know why she's still going on, right? Two people, same weight of presence. I don't understand what they're singing, but I'm going to pour it all out. I don't understand what's happening here, but I'm going to dance to my people. Same presence, two different opinions. Same presence, two different opinions. Judas was thinking about what he could have had, and Mary was thinking about what she could give. Where are you in that two spectrums? When you came in this morning, was it, well, I hope it's a good word because I need a word. Right? Oh God, I want to encounter the word. I want to encounter the word. I want my life to be full of it. I want the word to be manifest in this place. Same presence. Two different options. So even as we go into this Holy Week, I called my husband and our intercessors are amazing. Chandra was telling, she was saying, we're so happy we have happy intercessors because when you have a prophet pastor or an apostle prophet over you, you get things caught on you last minute. And I called them, I emailed them, I put it on their page. You're leaving this day, you're leaving this day, you're leaving this day. And they were like, yay! We called the fast last night. So you get to choose, right? I don't want to wake up at 6 a.m. I don't want to give up food from 9 to 5. We're doing water from 9 to 5. Water. I didn't even say liquids because we've got to learn how to push ourselves. Amen. Same presence this week. There's going to be two different responses. It's called Holy Week. The week in which he was betrayed. The week in which he died. The week in which he rose again. And we want to be very intentional this week. And the fast is called an alignment and awareness fast. God is going to align our hearts and our eyes, and he's going to make us aware of the weight of his life this week. We've been celebrating Easter for many, many years, but I felt like the Lord said this week there was a special presence on this week. Every Holy Week is special, but there is something on it. So I want to invite you guys into that fast. Amen. But take those 2 minutes, keep playing, and then you guys can sit down as we transition into announcements. Assess your heart. Have I made room for you, God? Waste my life for you, God? Is it too valuable? Is it too much time to give you? Matter of fact, before we make announcements, I want Mama Joyce to come out. She's going to share for about 5 minutes the outreach and evangelism team. The outreach and evangelism team went out yesterday. One thing about our teams in this church, we want our church members to understand, is that whatever activity the team does is not just for the team. The church is the team. So when we say there's outreach and evangelism, I don't care if you've never shared the gospel before. You're part of the church. This is an opportunity for you to be part of the team, right? March 30th, we have training for those who feel like they have a prophetic gift and those that are feel like they're called into the office of a prophet. If you are a member and you feel like you may be called in those areas, come. Right? When we have intercession, intercessory nights, you're part of the team. It's not just the intercessor's job. When the men pray, it's not just the lead men that pray. It's all the men that pray. Yeah. We are one family. Yeah. All right, come on, guys.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for worship. Thank you, God, for worship. Thank you, God, for worship. And I'm really, really thankful for what happened yesterday. We had a rough starting. You know, we were running late for various reasons. Myself and several of the people that came, we have been on this 40-day prayer at night. And Friday was day number 36, and our bodies are literally feeling it. So when she was talking about sacrifice, what you give, it resonated with me. Because there have been times when I would rather have gone to sleep, but 10 o'clock calleth. And the Lord gave us a mandate to do that for 40 days. And I'm so excited that He is overlapping it with the fast that starts tomorrow. Because when He gave us the mandate for the 40 days was to pray over the Lenten season, 40 days of Lent. And so as we go to the end of the 40 days on Tuesday, God called this fast for tomorrow. If you have not been fasting or praying with us at night, which I know most of you have not, because we can see it on the switchboard, be there tomorrow morning. If prayer just blesses you. I came here to talk about yesterday. So we came tired. I was really tired. I was telling Dr. Faith my body was hurting, but I pressed my way. And we came here and we didn't even have the implements that we needed to go do the work. But God is so faithful because Ashley, where are you, Ashley? Somewhere in here, right here. Ashley, who has not officially joined as a member of the team, came and she had 10 door hangers. None of us, evangelists had any, but we had the kids. Long story short, we wanted to go to this shopping center right here where the Target is and Panera Bread. And we stood in front of Target, not right at the entrance, but kind of further there. And Ashley and Faith, I don't know where Faith is, over there. They went to the apartments or townhouses and they gave out the cards. Ease with ease in one building, but they came to the other building. Ashley has a strong prophetic gift on her. They said they just sensed this presence that everybody in there pretty much said no, 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 no. So they came back to join us. I was with Sheila over here and Shavella. I don't know where Shavella is. And we were talking to people. We wanted them to go do their shopping. And as they came out, we spoke with them. And so she met several young people who had been looking for a church. They go to Chapel Hill. They live in Morrisville. They said they are coming and we'll be looking for them. And then there was a young man who was coming. I was sitting in my car because I wasn't feeling so well. But I was kind of, you know, watching and whatever. And so this young man is coming and the Spirit said, talk to him. And so I spoke with him and he didn't have a church. He was going to Durham to pick up his sister to bring her to Morrisville. But he lives in Cary. He was excited to learn about Legacy. And then I said, do you know the Lord? And he said, no. I said, do you know how to receive the Lord? He said, by prayer, I guess. So I said, okay, you can pray by yourself at home. I was just going to give him the script. Or we can pray with you here. And he said, pray with me here. You know, for a moment there, I was like, oh my God. But God is so faithful. Because before we left, we had a little quick lesson on how do you use Romans chapter 9 to bring somebody to the Lord. So we did that, and the team saw that, and he received. And he gave me his name and number, and he says he will be coming. And so the court security on us, which I had been sensing that, and I told Shabella, I said, I feel like they're going to call security on us. So the court security came. We were able to witness to the man too, and he told us his story. He wrote down legacycenter.com. We pray that he comes. So he told us to go look up this place, and I put it in GPS. I couldn't find it, so I said, you know what, I'll just park here. So we parked there, the team came, we prayed, we closed there, and everybody else left. I know it's probably a little more than 5 minutes. Everybody left. But Ashley said to me, she had something she wanted to talk to me about. So I said, okay, let's sit in the car. And we are sitting in the car and she's telling me all this stuff. And the windows were, you know, down. And from nowhere, this man is passing by. And I was like a crazy woman. But this is what the Holy Spirit does. And we have to get to that place where we let the Holy Spirit use us. Because if we are going to be self-conscious, God cannot use us. So I'm sitting in my car, and this man passes by. And I was like, sir, excuse me. Like a crazy woman. And he stopped instantly. So I got out, I said, I'm so sorry, I didn't mean to be disrespectful. Long story short, Ashley, we started talking to him, and he told us, this is important, he said, I don't know why I decided to walk for 1.5 miles. I could have taken an Uber, but I think God wanted me to meet with you. So I said, let's just pray. Ashley asked him if there was something we needed to pray about. And he said he had just lost his grandfather, and the viewing was Sunday. So we started, I said, Ashley, pray for him. And I'm so glad I need your hand. I'm so glad I did that, because as she was praying for him, as prophetic as she is, the Lord revealed some things to him. And so when we were done to her, when we were done praying, we shared those things with him. And he literally broke down right there in that parking lot and said, yeah, he cried. He said, this was a God thing. Yes. Now I understand why I did call Uber. Because God wanted me to meet you. He said, as I was walking for the 1.5 miles, I was talking to God and asking him certain things. I asked him for him to give me his voice. And you were the voice that I was looking for. He shared a lot of things with us. I don't have the time. Ashley can write it down in workplace or whatever. But it was so amazing. Because us sitting in that car, we thought we were just talking. But we had an appointment there. Missing the cinema was for a reason. Because God wanted us to be in that place. For this man who doesn't even live here. He's from Texas. He's a commercial airline, but was staying with a friend. So I thank God because he uses us to meet people out there. So next time when you hear that the outreach ministry is going out, please join us because God is working. Thank you. If you want to see the kingdom in action, it's going to be outside of the church. You have to make that a priority. So the prophetic team and the evangelism team will be joining together to do some amazing. We're going to see healings, people say deliverance outside. It's exciting. It's nerve-wracking at the beginning, but it'll be life-changing. So make sure to join in.
Kids are dismissed now at this time.